You know what's my favorite part about keeping reptiles and amphibians is making a beautiful habitat for my pets. And in today's video, I'm gonna go from this to this. And I'm gonna show you every step of the way of how I made this beautiful bioactive vivarium for my red-eyed tree frogs. My name's Ryan, and you're watching Mighty Morphin Reptiles. Let's roll the tape. For my enclosure build, I'm going to use a zoom in naturalistic terrarium that goes by the dimensions of 18 by 18 by 24 inches tall. Let's get it. So this terrarium came with its own background, but I decided to remove it as I want to make my own custom background. And I usually like to practice my hardscape pieces first, especially with these branches since they're going to be for red-eyed tree frogs. I then start my custom background by using expanding foam, the water foam sealant, as this is waterproof and it's way better than the yellow stuff. Honestly, the yellow stuff is crap and this always sticks really well for me, so yeah, I totally recommend this for a foam. Next, I'm going to be placing some cork bark on the foam before it dries up, and cork bark is my jam. I just love the texture of it, and plus it'll go really well for a tree frog vivarium. Alright, my expanding foam is dry now, and I put my branches in, and then I secured it with some masking tape. I decided I wanted my branches to come from one side and like swoop over to the other side with these ones. And I just like the idea of it has a little bit of flow that swoops over. And it's gonna be really fun to watch my tree frogs hop around on these branches when it comes. Then I secured the branch down with some foam and waited a few hours for it to cure out. Now the foam around the branches is finally dried up and I'm gonna cut up the masking tape and just try to get them off. Yeah, I like the way it's starting to look. Definitely happy with it so far. All right, yeah, totally loving that right there. See, yeah, you guys see where I was going with this. Now it's gonna like stick out and actually look like legit branches. You know, I started looking at it and I felt like it was kind of naked at branches, so I grabbed this other piece of Malaysian driftwood that I had lying around and I decided to stick it right there underneath the cork. And I thought that actually went really well, and it's just gonna look more natural how it comes up like that. Yeah, definitely the frogs are gonna love this. All right, let's put some expanding foam down. Then I let it cure out for a few hours. Then I begin carving all the smooth surfaces off the foam, and we can't have any of the smooth surfaces here for the next part. Otherwise, whatever I'm gonna adhere to it next will not stick at all. And you know what, once I looked at it again, I realized that it just needed more cork bark along the background, like in between the branches, next to the Malaysian driftwood. And sometimes, you know, you can't just really plan things out. Sometimes it just comes to you along the way. And I feel like some of the best forms of art are really like that, you know? And I'm glad I added the extra cork because I really wanted to make it look like my frogs are actually in the trees. For this next part, I decided to use foot wrap to wrap around my branches just because for what we're gonna do, I really don't want to get all over my branches and ruin everything. Now I'm gonna be trying this new method I discovered about. It's called the dry lock method. And if you don't know what dry lock is, all it is like a liquid cement that you paste all over your expanding foam and it makes more of like this hardened background, which will look pretty good. With dry lock, you're gonna wanna put two coats over it. For the first coat, I decided not even color it in and just put it all over. But just plain light gray would be boring, so I mixed up some light brown, pasted it all around the cork bark and branches. I then decided to add a second coat of dry lock, a darker gray color this time, and then I wanted to add more details of black along it, and this is how my finished product came out, and I'm much happier with the look of this now. I then added a small bead of black silicone all along the foam background just for extra safe measure, because it would really suck if it did fall over. Then I add Leica clay pebbles for the drainage layer, and then I put the substrate barrier over the drainage layer, and I gotta say, this thing's such a pain always for me to put over nice and evenly. Then I add my homemade terrarium substrate and I get it up to about 2 to 3 inches tall, and I'll leave a video link in the description on how I made it. I then decided to push my dirt up towards the back so it would have a little bit of a depth look. And now let's get to the favorite part, planting. And this is a really beautiful new Rgb that I found and I'm so excited for it. I then decided to put it right there on the top of the Malaysian driftwood. I just use a little bit of glue. I'm gonna be trying out this new product I found, ZooMed Frog Moss, and they state that it'll come back to life under the right conditions, but honestly, I don't really know how to feel about that. But I'm gonna be placing along the cork. I just kind of wanted to make it look a little more naturalistic as I do this. And plus, moss is always one of the coolest looks you can have in a vivarium. And I hope it really complements the frogs I'm going to be putting in here. Oh, and I just have this moss being held down by using some floor wire. I just stick it through the moss and then have it poking through inside the foam. And it holds it down pretty well. I'm definitely happy with the look of this moss. And now I'm going to be planting this beautiful philodendron monstera that I got at my local nursery. And they actually just use organic potting soil, so I don't have to worry about rinsing out all the roots and stuff, because usually they have fertilizer in it and that's really harmful for the frogs, but this is pet safe already. And plus, these frogs love big broad leaves and it's going to work really well for them. And plus, I love the look of it too. Look at that heart-shaped little leaf right there with holes in it. It's so beautiful. And next, I'm going to be adding leaf litter all along the bottom of the vivarium. And this is really important for the frogs because their skin's really sensitive, so you do not want them touching that soil. And then I just decided to add some fake cereal rock stone. And this is just completely for aesthetics. And I thought it'd be good for more ground cover area for the frogs to leap across. And plus, watching frogs leap is always really cute, am I right? And then I'm gonna be adding a clean dish of water, and it's always important for frogs to have a clean source of water for them to bathe and drink out of. And since tap water has chlorines, I always use Repti Safe, and I totally recommend this product, and it's really cheap to use. And now I'm just gonna give my vivarium a good misting, wash it down, keep it moist, give a little bit of moisture in all the soil, and give the plant some water. Alright guys, now for the final touch, let's add some springtails. I just use the turkey baster, suck them up, and then I drip them in the vivarium a few times. And these guys are really great at eating algae, mold, and fungus. And now I'm going to be adding some orange isopods, and these guys are really great at eating up the poop. And combined with the springtails, these guys are completely like janitors, and I barely will ever have to clean up the poop except along the glass and leaves. And these guys are amazing to have, as combined together and they make like a complete ecosystem. You have very little maintenance. And now it's time for the star of the show, the red-eyed tree frogs. I'm so excited to finally add them in. And I bet I totally surprised you. You thought I was gonna put the green ones in. Nope, I totally fooled you there. And these guys are so freaking cute. I mean, look at them. Gosh, I'm so excited. And look how cute he looks on that leaf right there. Man. Red-eyed tree frogs are nocturnal, but that's totally okay with me, as I like being up late at night too. And these guys are so much fun to watch during the night. They are super active. They're like little monkeys in their cage jumping around everywhere. And I gotta say guys, it was so much freaking fun making this vivarium for my red-eyed tree frogs, and I'm so happy with the way it came out. I've been loving watching these guys hop around at night, jumping from branch to branch, leaf to leaf, and just eating all these cute little bugs. And I realized I totally forgot to show you guys what kind of light I got. So I got a Hygger 24/7 LED aquarium light. What's really special about this light is it has a 24/7 night cycle mode, meaning like in the morning, it'll have like that sunrise effect where it'll be all orange, it'll get brighter throughout the day, and as the evening comes, and go back down, and then it'll give that moonlight effect, and it's just been so awesome. I love this feature and it's amazing, and the plants are growing really well for them. And also, I want to give a special shout out to my buddy Brandon from Evolution Exotics for hooking me up with these red-eyed tree frogs, and I love them so freaking much. And if you guys got some value out of this video, then please hit and smash that like and subscribe button, and I'll see you guys on the next one. My name's Ryan, and you're watching Mighty Morphin Reptiles.